And we're back with another episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG chick, as always. We just camped, and we're ready to kill some forest lurkers.
Yeah.
We owe them a rematch.
And what does the flame reveal?
It reveals forest lurkers. And they are our chosen prey at the moment. I'm pretty sure there's going to be two of them. They're around here somewhere. Clearing out the fog of war. Plus, we've been here before, but died, sadly. Okay, so there's another way. That way. Road kind of ends here. They must be at the very edge. Either that, or it was just a random chance for them to appear. I really had a score to settle with them. There's one of them. Switching to ranged weapons. Alright, did him, right? No. Yeah, I did. Okay. They're tough. They are tough. Let's give her that much. See how much of us to kill this time, or knock out. Oh well, if they knock out all of us, then we are dead. If we can, attack the one that's damaged. Although we kind of have to walk next to this one to do it. Move our priest up a little so we can get people with his holy radiance. We can do this. Speaker to the restless. Fill them with dread, unless they're mindless things, in which case, probably won't do anything. I don't know. Necrotic Lance. Pretty friggin' damaging spell. Let's go. Attack. Oh crap, one hit.
Lava will be on seek.
Did he miss? Shrine of Galloween. Up here? Oh, cool. Definitely gotta check that out. That's what they were guarding. Missed with the forest. Don't miss. Come on. Let's do one of his better healing spells right off the bat. Who's behind him? Get like that. Amplified thrust? She didn't do it yet? Oh no, she's not doing it. She's doing that. Never mind. Never mind. And he's gonna do that. And he's gonna do that, so. Okay, that was his light endurance, right? Yeah, that helps. Holy Radiance. Did that work? Did that fill them with dread? And now, Amplified Thrust off of Eater. Oh, he got him with the lance, didn't he? Grazed him. You still can cast another one? Cast on the Forest Lurker again. And we're gonna do Soul Shock off of Eater. And the priest's still doing his thing. I think now he's done. Shield. Whatever kind of shield. Holy shield, whatever it is. Lava will be on sea. Are really tough. Okay, he just launched that. Oh, he is launching. Okay. Another minor or light endurance. Wait, who is this? That's Eater. Okay, he's fine. I'm not even hitting him. It's turning to her, isn't it? Well, she's going to attack now anyway. Because she's out of focus for her spells. You know what? Is it engage with... I don't want to cast Fan of Flames, it's going to get one of us. Maybe if you can stand right here. I'm not sure if you can fan it out like that. Oh, this thing's healing him automatically. Oid Wrecked heals Eater for 2 endurance. Kanna could really use that thing right now. He still has yet to cast this. Okay. Okay, Aelath. Moved over, right? This is him. Alright. He's by the front lines, which is not good, but maybe he can cast Fan of Flames. Hit Eater in the process. I hate that. I don't think he can do it. Let's daze these things. Try this. It's bound to look cool. Okay. How about Divine Terror? Can we cast it already? Tough. This one's really damaged now. Blessing. Blessing, yeah. Now, who is it hitting? Aloth and Firebrand? Ow, she got hit. Let's see if she can do this. Oh wait, she's... No, that's not her. What? Let me just see the particulars on this mind wave. Foe AoE. Okay, so supposedly it only hurts foes. I have the right one selected. Mind wave. Yeah. Is that it? Yeah, that's it. Ooh. She is getting hit badly. Gaunt's pledge for her. Missile. This one's almost out, and that one's not far behind. And she's okay again, so attack. Now we can cast more stuff here. Barbs of Condemnation. Let's heal again. This will be our last one. Die, beast! Ooh, boy! One more use of that Gaunt's pledge. Oh, hey. Cool! Awesome. Everyone on this damn thing. Everyone on this damn thing. Nice. Oof. And none of us died. We got banged up a little bit, that's for sure. Hey. Awakened wood. This irregular chunk of wood seems to hold a trace of life within it. Hmm. That's pretty good, let's save. That was a mighty battle indeed. With the frickin' Avengers, man, in medieval times. Or fantasy times.
Hello? Hello?
Shut up. Who sneaks around yelling hello, hello? Oh, looks something here, too. Deer cap. Yay! Cleared the map. Ooh, discover something.
something over there.
Yeah. Trees and shrub have grown up around these ancient bones, shrouding this monument to Galloween beneath their leaves. An altar. Ooh, with a fine wand. A scroll of ray of fire. Creates a scorching ray of flame between the caster and the target, inflicting continual burn damage to the target and anyone caught in the ray. Bring all this to our resident wizard. Scroll of prayer against fear. This is a priest spell. Steals the mind of allies in the area of effect against all external fears, granting bonus resistance against attacks with frightened or terrified afflictions and reducing the duration of any such afflictions currently on the target. And 17 golden dukes. I'm not completely sure if just anyone can cast these scrolls. You just need the lore to do so. That's what I'm kind of guess is the way, but I'm not sure. Okay, so we finished Black Meadow. I feel really accomplished. All these places that we've been to. Three of them. In the last two episodes. The Skulder King and finished off the Temple of Aethas. Finished off that bear in the cave and now defeated these forest lurkers. Ooh, Esternwood. That's where we need to go, isn't it? Well, we're not headed to Defiance Bay yet, I guess. We're looking for a secret entrance into Raedric's hold. You know what? I'm gonna go back and get some rest and more camping supplies. One more camping supply. Because we're kind of passing by the area, aren't we? I know there's a way to speed things up, guys, with these, but every time I go to do it, I don't remember the keys, and every time I'm not playing, I forget to look to see what key does that. It doesn't seem to be here. So, let's look in the journal, actually. The bestiary. I love looking at the bestiary. Forest Lurker. Lurkers are actually comprised of a colony of several different species of parasitic carnivorous plants and fungi working together to hunt common prey. As a whole, they stand nearly 10 feet tall in vaguely anthropomorphic body comprised of vines, leaves, roots, and earth. The coexistence of so many separate organisms can make them hard to eradicate, and it is usually best to sever the parts that enable locomotion or to simply light the entire colony on fire. While the means by which lurkers form remains a bit of a mystery, some speculate that the form when certain species of flesh-eating plants come together on a common host, such as the hollowed victims of dank spores, and achieve locomotion once sufficiently strong. That they form. Okay, I'm still getting sentences cut off here. They gotta fix that. I was like, that sentence doesn't make sense. They form. That's right. Okay. This theory is supported by the fact that many lurkers, when cut open, contain bones and other remains riddled with roots and spores. Oh, I don't seem to have found that. Lurkers are notorious for hiding in plain sight, often waiting motionless amongst the trees and underbrush to ambush their prey. They appear to hold a rudimentary intelligence and are at least sophisticated enough to store food. It is not uncommon to see several unconscious victims tangled in a lurker's vines being saved for later feeding. Ugh. All right, what else? Sure if I read this. Doesn't seem familiar. So this is for the stone beetle, but it looks like it's just talking about beetles in general. Like the wood beetle here. Yeah. Just saying about beetles in general. Beetles are not quite man-sized, but they strike a sufficiently intimidating form to frighten off most travelers. The alarmingly large insects never fail to impress and terrify visitors and reinforce the image of the Deerwood as a barely civilized backwater. The expansive wilderness in and around Deerwood and Ir Glanfath gives beetles plenty of room to multiply. The most successful species of large beetle have evolved to not only camouflage themselves in the surrounding environment, but also grow carapaces made out of common and hardy materials such as wood, stone, and adra. Glanfath and tribes have been known to fashion crude shields and even weapons out of the limbs and shells of these beetles. Despite all appearances to the contrary, there is an underlying complexity to the common beetle. When they choose a material with which to develop their shell, they do so with a level of intention that borders on artistry. Wood beetles will often burrow intricate holes in their carapaces. By blowing air through these makeshift pipes, they play an eerie music to attract mates. Wow. Stone beetles fashion rudimentary tusks and horns that help them to defend themselves and to attack prey. The intricacies of adra beetles are as of yet not well understood, save that they are notoriously difficult to kill. Wow. So we're going to fight them at some point. So the wind blight we fought once, along with, crap, what's his name? That multiple personality guy that we were forced to kill. These amorphous clouds rapidly swirl with violent energy. Within the maelstrom, dozens of humanoid shapes materialize and vanish within an instant. Faces scream in silent agony while hands desperately clutch and claw at the air around the mask. Beowicks, spirit winds as these storms are known, often create blights. You know, I think we might have fought this once before. Up in the, outside in, Cadnua. Right? I got it right? I remembered something? Remember the name? If souls are ripped free of bodies and caught in the center of the storm, they may become stuck together and bonded with any other elemental substances in the maelstrom. They are pure chaos and confusion, and destroying them is considered a mercy to the souls trapped within. Experimenting with blight creation is yet another questionable activity that has earned animancers a bad reputation in many circles. Some see it as dangerous and inhumane, others as a means to an end. The creation of blights is an accusation, and many fearful kith level at animancers. Alright.
Hail, traveler.
Thank you. Hail, hail. So, like, decrease of accuracy. I don't know if it's worth it to even use that thing. But I'm not sure if we should sell it either, so I guess we'll just hold on to it. Take that. And that, while we're at it. Can't sell the pet. Seems silly to have that in game, you know, so. And camping supplies. One.
Hail and well met.
Let's take the Deerwood's pride again. Alright, so we got the bonus of +2 resolve. We can head on our quest to Raedric's Hold. Not gonna get to do too much with it because we're almost up with our half hour and my disc is almost full. I need another hard drive, that's for sure. I wonder if we can just come out this way and go...
No problem.
...where we want to go. Hours, huh? Just there. Looks like it's practically next door. Good. Esternwood. No one needs to level up or anything?
Quickly and quietly.
Should we stray from the path? Can we stray from the path? No, not yet. Oh, we can look at this tree, though. Warding symbols as red and rough as scabs have been carved into some of the trees. East to Raedric's Hold and west to Gilded Vale. Let's go through here. I like to explore the map in a roundabout fashion. Lots of stuff to look at here with these trees. More warding symbols. Is that going to affect us negatively in battle or something? Yeah, we got something here. Burned Lady. We have that. We've seen that before, right? Yeah. Not new.
Yeah.
Run, dear. I mean you no harm. Oh, what's going on with the earth over here? Cradle. I love how the earth is cracked like that. Oh, those wick things. There's bound to be more. But maybe we'll fell this one. Doesn't seem to be very strong, it's just their strength lies in numbers.
Eh?
One down. Three more. So far. Get this one. He's probably going to reach us first. I'm employing my usual strategies, that's all. This one's probably gonna fall really quick, so let me just launch a magic missile type thing over at that one. Oh, they're hitting hard, aren't they? Much about this Chanter character. Yeah.
keeping an eye out.
Making tracks. Whole south area of the map is already
got it.
Explored. More vessel flesh. Should I go a little more? Okay, unfortunately I ran out of disk space again. We just went back. Fright was somewhere around here. I just went back to the road here and then noticed I was no longer recording. So I'll see you in the next episode when we explore the middle and northern portions of the map. Thanks for watching as always. Endure, and enduring, grow strong.